This is the C2H2Cl2 Lewis structure. Carbon has 4 valence electrons, 2 carbons. Hydrogen has 1, but we have 2 hydrogens, plus chlorine, which is 7. We have 2 chlorines for a total of 24 valence electrons. Carbon's the least electronegative. We'll put that in the center, and we know hydrogens always go on the outside. But here's the problem. Where do we put the hydrogens? Do we do it like this, where we have 2 hydrogens on one side and 2 chlorines on the other? Or do we do it like this, where we have a hydrogen and a chlorine on one side, and then on the other we have a hydrogen and chlorine? They're very different chemical compounds. They have different properties. So we can't really tell, looking at this structure up here, which way we're supposed to do it. So let's go with this right now. We have 24 valence electrons for the C2H2Cl2 Lewis structure. We'll put 2 electrons between atoms to form the chemical bonds, like this. So we've used 10, then around the chlorines, 12, 22, and then back to the central carbons, 24, but we've used all 24 valence electrons. We can see that both hydrogens have 2 valence electrons, and that's all they need for a full outer shell. And that this carbon here has 8, the chlorine has 8, and this chlorine has 8 as well. Their octets are completed. However, this carbon right here only has 6, so we're going to have to share electrons to form a double bond in order to get it to 8 valence electrons. Let's move these 2 valence electrons here into the center to form a double bond. We're still using only 24 valence electrons, but now this carbon here has 8 valence electrons, as does this. So the octets are complete on all the atoms in the C2H2Cl2 Lewis structure. For this structure, because we have the chlorines on the first and second carbons, we're going to call it 1,2-dichloroethene. If both chlorines were on the first carbon, it'd be 1,1-dichloroethene. That's the Lewis structure for C2H2Cl2. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.